Dave here with another video. Today I want to talk about Fundrise and why I decided to go with their supplemental income plan. Let's get started. So here we are logged into the main page of Fundrise. This is what you get if you're an investor and you're logged in. We can, you know, basically see an overview of what's going on here. I got $10,000 invested, and I kind of ramped that up over the last almost a year. It's been about 10 months or so. But what I want to talk about today is the supplemental income plan and the other two plans that they have available as well. Why did I go with the supplemental income plan? Well, there's a few reasons why. But first, let's just talk about real quick what the options even are. So let's pop those up here. So on this page, we have a listing of the six plans I was talking about. If you have anything less than $10,000, then you can invest in the standard plans. And you know, if you have $10,000 and above, then you can invest in the plus plans. You can upgrade your plan. So really what that does is just kind of, you know, more risk adverse basically. It's probably across, you know, not totally different things, but it has a lot more options, I'd say. They don't really necessarily tell you. It does say sophisticated investments, you know, whether that's opportunity zones or maybe it's just bare land that they subdivide and, you know, make a neighborhood or something out of it. There's a lot of different options that you could, you know, consider to be sophisticated. So, but let's just talk about supplemental income versus balanced investing in a long-term growth plan. So the supplemental income plan really is just, you know, apartment complexes, you know, that already have renters in there. You know, it could be maybe in a school area or something like that, but they're already getting rent from the place, okay? And it's basically been, they've been collecting rent. It's basically like a fine-tuned clock at this point. And, you know, they pretty much know what money they're going to get from it. You know, it might appreciate, you might get a little bit of money from that because, you know, the supplemental income has a little bit less appreciation in the diversification. So, and then the balanced investing is kind of a mix between, I'd say maybe it could be 50-50 of, you know, what I just talked about in the supplemental income plan where, you know, you're in apartment complexes where they're already rented out versus, you know, buying apartment complex that needs to be renovated and then renting it out, you know, wait for it to appreciate and then sell it, right? So they probably could, they could wait, you know, for anywhere from 5 to 10 years, depending on the market, before they sell these properties. But they do have a core list of properties that you're gonna collect that rent on, which they can pay the dividends from. So let's talk about the long-term growth, and that is kind of just more geared towards building up an apartment complex from scratch on bare land, or possibly even just taking an apartment complex that's been distressed quite badly and renovating it, fixing it up, renting everything out and selling it, or just renting it out and then converting it over to the supplemental, you know, portfolio per se, right? So that, and it has, you know, the long-term growth does pay dividends. It does have, you know, has core holdings in there that they do collect rent from as well. So that kind of just tells you how they split up the three. You know, you're gonna get possibly with a long-term growth plan, you have the opportunity to make a little bit more in appreciation, which overall could make your returns a little bit higher. The balanced investing is kind of, you know, just that, it's a balance, right? It's just in between supplemental income plan and the long-term growth plan. So it's kind of a mix, it's a mixed bag with the returns kind of being in the middle. And then the supplemental income, you know, it's got a little bit smaller return range, but at least you know what you're gonna get every month, right? Because the appreciation is kind of not as big as a factor. So let's just kind of go over these real quick here. Plus plans, you know, like I said earlier, it's basically the same type of mix as these here, but they might throw in a couple of different things, or they could throw in other things in there that are more sophisticated is what they call them. I don't know if they're doing opportunity zones or not. I think you can invest with opportunity zones with them. If you're not really sure what those are, so they're basically, you know, certain areas in the nation that got, I don't want to say approved or nominated or something like that, but, you know, they're distressed areas and, you know, it's kind of brought by the government to say, okay, let's bring in, you know, let's allow people to, you know, bringing 1031 exchange money into opportunity zones. There's different things that you can bring in opportunity zones, and it's tax-free. The capital gains are tax-free if you keep it in there for so long. So, you know, there's certain areas that you can invest in. I don't know where all they are. I did look them up recently because I wanted to possibly 1031 my recent rental, which I do have a video, and I'll link it in the top here and why I got out of rentals. So, but that's something they could be doing in these plus plans as well. You know, they could also be buying bare land and then subdividing up or making, you know, a neighborhood or something out of it as well. but let's talk about why I decided to go with the supplemental income plan. Okay, well, I'm on the supplemental income plus plan now, but why did I go with that? So I went with it because I'm about 12 to 36 months away from retirement, okay? That is one of the reasons why I selected to go with the supplemental income plan is number one, I wanted to know, kind of get an idea of what my turns would be with this platform, okay? I don't want to have any surprises, right? And having appreciation is a surprise, okay? So, you know, it's 2019, we're, you know, tip-topsy in the market right now, right? Real estate is doing good. We're at the signs of a bubble again, just like back in 2006, 2007. So how do we know that? Well, I know it just because I kind of remember how it was back then a little bit, right? It's always different every time, but you know, when you got people talking about it, it's in the news all the time. People are flipping. Everyone's getting into flipping and stuff. That tells you that we are in a bubble, okay? So I do flip homes as well, and I'm going to do some videos on those, and I will do a video on that short, actually soon. So the second reason why I went with a supplemental income plan is because, just like I said, I don't know what's going to happen with the market, right? If they're, you know, investing in brand new construction projects or whatever, if we are in a recession, then, you know, cost of materials go up, the cost of construction goes up, you know, people lose jobs, you know, companies go under. How long is it going to take them to finish a project? Can they get a buyer for the project? Can they find people to even move into these places that pay the amount of rent that can even support a multi-unit apartment complex? So to me, it was just the less riskier option, right? If I'm close to retirement and I want to know what money I'm going to be getting from this platform in retirement, then that's, in my opinion, going with supplemental income plan kind of reduces that risk just a little bit, you know, but it does lower down the return a little bit, right? But it's not very much. It's 1 or 2%. It's not, you know, it's not that much, right? The potential's there to gain in the other ones, but at this point, you know, a couple percent doesn't matter to me. If you look at my returns right now, just based off the last dividend I got, you know, of $187 here, you times it by four, divide it basically by about 10,100, that comes out to about 7.4%, okay? So I can live with that. That's really good. Matter of fact, I'm gonna talk about real estate notes in another video and, you know, what I get from that as well versus my rentals that I had. So kind of want to do a comparison between them all, but 7.4, I'm happy with that all day long. You want to give me that, that's fine, okay? I don't care. I would rather have it in something that's less risky where, you know, I don't have to worry about, you know, as much per se, you know, just to get 1 or 2 more percent out of it, okay? So right now I do have my dividends just reinvesting. I'm kind of just letting this compound a little bit. I will be adding some more money to this as well. But so that's, you know, the overview of the reason why I selected to go with that plan. So, you know, I'm kind of curious to know what plan you're going with. If you haven't invested with them, then, you know, what have you thought about going with? So with that, let's go ahead and end this video, and we'll see in the comments. If you have any questions, go and leave a comment below. Go ahead and don't forget to like and subscribe if this video helped you out, and we'll see you in the next one.